let me know if I brushed you hard. Okay, so I am going to get your end. But I'd had so little control over my own emotions that I was making something that I had done into something that they were trying to help me with. You're just looking for trim or a full haircut. What were you thinking? Okay. So probably a bit of a trim, but you want to reshape your bangs a little bit. Okay. And you're good with color? Do you want highlights or anything like that? Okay. So I'm seeing some layers here, some face framing layers that might have been a little grown out by now. Did you want to keep those in? The length in the back. I notice it's a little bit shorter, like maybe you had like an A-line cut. Yeah. And maybe, do you want it to be brought to all one length? Or did you want me to redo the A-line cut so that it can be like it was before? Okay. I can do that. Just let me put this around you. Good. Okay. So I think I'm going to start some brushing. Is that okay? Let me know if I brushed you hard or anything like that, okay? So how's your day been going? Do you have any plans once your appointment is finished? Freshened up. Very good. This is your natural hair color. looks really good with your skin tone. You're very much a summer tone. And it looks really good and fitting. Of course, I'm a believer in you can do any color you want. I don't think there should be types that restrict. Decisions that we want to make with our hair or our clothes. I think we should do whatever we want. And as someone who loves a bit of color theory, I think it looks really good. Have you gone to this place before? The place that you're going after your appointment. Oh, okay. Seems like a nice place. I've driven past it a couple of times. Never knew what it was from the outside. To me about anything you want. Just don't confess to murder to me. I have a friend who's from the city. He was telling me that one of his clients who's giving this elderly woman a perm, and I guess she was maybe just getting to an age where she said, who cares, and started to talk about how she buried her husband under the flower beds, and he wasn't really sure. She was just messing with him, so she just, she got her perm finished, and he did call the, non-emergency hotline, and they said that she tells that story a lot, but that they've met her husband, and they still live together, and she's quite a jokester, apparently. But can you imagine? Can you imagine if that was real? Anyway, I'm sorry, that's so, such a dark mood when you're gonna have such interesting plans later, but anyway, you can talk to me about anything. I'm an open book, for sure. Okay. I'm gonna start spritzing your hair and get it nice and wet so we can do the cut, okay? Alright. bit of a scent to it. A hint of rose. I think it smells really good. And just want to make sure that for about 2 years now, and it's been a very interesting journey, and it's been very fun. I get to meet a lot of really interesting people, and most people are really very nice. I'm grateful for. There are some not so nice people, but most of the people that I work with are really, really fun to get to see, and I always feel good inside when they come back for their trim and they ask for me by name. There's no pressure. I want you to be happy with your hair, and if that includes me, then I would love that, but if someone else can do it better, I would want them to do it better. Okay? I would want you to be here, and I am most happy. I am most happy when you are happy. Okay. So just going to comb this through. So, for your little face framing layers, are you thinking about this one that's grown out to like here? And maybe the next one to here? Does that sound good? Would you like it a little bit shorter, or what are you thinking today? Okay. Well, why don't we just start with just a little? And we can always go shorter. We can go longer. Okay. Okay. I don't know how freaked out I would get when someone was doing my hair and they weren't checking in with me during the process. And so I try to, now that I am a hairstylist, I try to be really careful. Just gonna get this little knot out. Let me know if this hurts. I want to be really careful since people's hair's so important to them. And can be a very upsetting experience. And I want this to be a fun experience. Okay. Okay. So let us just start out this part right here. Okay. So I'm just going to. Okay. So I am going to go here and How's that? Feels good. Okay. You can just look in the mirror and you'll be part of the process the whole time. Okay. So just... Right. Okay. Here's what I want. Okay. So we're just going to go here. Okay. Now just match it on the side. Perfect. Now we're just going to make them even. Okay. You want it to be really even. Okay. Just look in the mirror, what do you think? Looking good? Okay. So we're just gonna do the next layers. Okay. Just set this right here. Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's so sweet. I think that's just lovely. Spritz you a little bit more here. Just cover your eye. Just come on now. There we go. So this is matching here, here, and here. I was thinking it looks like the A-line faded into these front ones. So I want to know if you'd like to go shorter in the very front, or if you want to keep the full length. And then when we go from the back to the front, we can adjust the gradient or whatever. Okay? Okay. You see, when I keep it a bit long in the front. Okay. So, alright. So that means we're just gonna go back here. Okay. Just a little bit off. Ourselves worked, it would have worked by now. You wouldn't be having, you know, you wouldn't be doing these things, you know, if they'd really had worked the way they were supposed to, you know. If hating yourself could turn you into a better person, some of us would have long since become the champion. Tell you what, I would have been the best person possible in my 20s. For example, I think that, you know, let's say I was feeling ashamed of something that I'd done, or I felt guilty because I'd accidentally, or rather unintentionally, had hurt a friend or something like that. And, you know, maybe I made a joke or something. And it unintentionally hurt their feelings. In the past, what I probably would have done was, well, I mean, it depends. There's a time in my life where I would have been like, oh, I didn't mean it like that. Please don't get upset. That's not what I meant. Things like that. I felt really bad. Or I would have apologized a lot. Excessively, even. To the point that I almost would keep apologizing because I wanted them to stop being upset faster. That if they saw how sorry I was, then maybe the conflict would go away faster, but this more had the effect of it made them feel like they had to the one that had hurt their feelings. And there might have even been a time where I was realizing that even though I was very upset that I'd hurt their feelings, they were starting to switch gears and start trying to make me less upset, and then I would feel guilty about that. And then I would feel ashamed of myself that I'd had so little control over my own emotions, that I was making something that I had done into something that they were trying to help me with. And that spiral of shame would just keep going. And this would, one, not do what I really, really wanted, which was to simply not hurt my friend, you know? And by all of this happening, it would hurt my friendships more because they felt like they couldn't talk to me if I did something wrong, because then I would have such a huge reaction over it. And so eventually I started to try to become comfortable with the hot potato. You know, there's gotta be a middle ground. Where can feel guilty for the impact that you caused, but that you don't use that knowledge as a stick to beat yourself with. Instead, what you do is what I would do now is I would apologize to my friend, let them know that I understand why it was hurtful and what steps I'll take to prevent this from happening in the future, and leave it at that. And if they're still angry, if it's, they need space, to just let them be. In the past, I would be messaging and messaging. And like, please respond to me this, I'm so upset that you're not responding. Like, it's hard to be in that place where you have to admit that you're wrong. You have to find a way to do it that doesn't make you hate yourself, because then that doesn't, it doesn't help your friend, it doesn't help you. It doesn't make you into the person that you want to be. All of the shame and self-deprecation that I went through, it didn't make me into the friend that I wished that I was. It just turned me into a mess. And would make me feel terrible and make me feel more like I didn't belong around people that were nice because I was messing it up. So what I would do now, I would apologize. I would tell them I know what I did wrong, the steps that I would take to prevent it in the future. Do you think that is looking like the length and angle that you're wanting for the A cut? A little less steep. Okay. I can do that. And if they wanted space, I would give them space. If an amount of time had passed that I couldn't get it off my mind, I might message them, not right away, depending on the severity of it. Could be a couple hours, could be a couple days. Say, hey, I know you might still be upset with me, and you don't have to rush, I just want you to know that I'm thinking about you, and if there's anything I can do, let me know. Otherwise, I'll let you come to me, basically. And I feel like a lot of times it's gone so much better. I think that getting comfortable with accepting that you did something wrong, but using some self-compassion is what really made the difference, because if I spent all that time being like, you messed up, you're terrible, you hurt other people, I wouldn't have been able to have the calmness to deal with the situation the way I wanted to. Even if I was really worried, I would be spending my time trying to cope with the anxiety I was feeling instead of hurting myself or freaking out. And it's not easy, but it's better. I'm sorry, I just have this thing. It helps. It's my little guy. And, anyway. Usually, things don't get as bad as they were, where people need a lot more time away because it doesn't escalate so much, because before, it would be like, it would get so escalated because of my own shame spiral that people would need more time away. But now, because I can be like, oh man, I'm really sorry. Thank you for letting me know. I will keep that in mind. Sometimes it can just be so quick. Anyway. Having compassion for yourself is important. In those moments, I might be like, yes, you upset a friend. Yes, you did the wrong thing. But you know what you did. And these emotions, it's just your brain and your soul telling you that this is not aligned with who you want to be. So just remember this. This distress is a lesson, not a punishment. I don't want to feel this way again. So I won't do this again. And it's seeing the discomfort as like if you stubbed your toe, you'd think, well, I'll be careful when I'm walking around that corner. You know, it's not meant to be a punishment. And if you say to yourself, you know, I want to be a person that people can talk to if I do something that upsets them. And that's more important to me than punishing myself, because punishing myself historically has not worked. It didn't make me work, do things better. It just made me hate myself more. And it's not effective. If it was the way that things worked, I wouldn't have had these problems. I would have been a model citizen, a model friend. I think everything is looking really good. I know I've just been gabbing away. But I hope that you're going to really like it. So, thank you for listening to me ramble. We're gonna be doing a bit of a blow dry, okay? So, I'm not gonna be talking anymore. So, thank you. Hopefully that wasn't annoying. Okay. perfect. You can look over in the mirror. What do you think? Great. Yeah, I was trying to get these two parts to be the same length. And I think we've accomplished that. If you turn a little bit, you have the nice, good angle to the side that you wanted from the back to the front. And we got everything else exactly the way you wanted. Got it nice and blown out. What do you think? Perfect. Alright. Did you want to schedule your trim in, let's say, about 6 weeks? It's up to you. You can decide. Front desk. Okay. I think it looks really good. I almost wish that we'd done a before picture. Okay. Ah, sorry. I gotta stop playing with your hair, and I see that my other client is very patiently waiting. They're very early, so don't feel bad. But okay. I hope that you really like it, and maybe I'll see you in 6 weeks. Alrighty. Okay. Just, yeah, it's just back up this way and then around that